This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to show how to solve some word problems involving percent. So here's the first problem. Andy has 240 toy cars. 20% of the cars are red. How many red cars are there? Okay, so the unknown in this problem is the number of red cars that we're looking for. We'll use an x to represent that number, and I'm going to make that x the numerator of a fraction. The denominator is going to be the total number of toy cars, 240. So we've got this fraction or ratio, and I'm going to set it equal to the percent. I've got 20%, but instead of writing that as a percent, I'm going to write it as a fraction. So I'll just write the 20, and instead of a percent sign, I'll put that 20 over 100. So now I've got two fractions that create an equation. X over 240 equals 20 over 100. The first thing I want to do to solve this is get the x by itself, which means getting rid of the 240 in this denominator. So I'll do that by multiplying both sides by 240. On the left side, 240 will cancel out, and all I'll have is x. On the right side of the equation, I have to multiply 20 times 240. Well, 2 times 24 is 48. And then I'll add two more zeros for each of the zeros that I had in those numbers. And I've got to divide that by 100. So that's going to mean that I have x equal to 48. That's going to be the number of red cars. Okay, so let's just review this and then we'll go on to one more. I started out by making a fraction, a ratio. I took the number of cars, of red cars, as the numerator. We didn't know what that was, so I just used an x for that. The denominator was the total number of cars. I set that equal to the percent that I had, but I wrote the percent as a fraction. So I had x over 240 equals 20 over 100. And then all I had to do was solve that equation to find out what x was, and I got the number of red cars. Okay, let's try one more. If a bicycle that normally sells for $495 is on sale for 10% off, how much will it cost? Well, we've got to do this problem in two steps. First, we've got to find out how much 10% of 495 is. That's going to be the discount, the amount that's subtracted from the original price. And then what we'll do is subtract that 10%, whatever number we find, from the original price, and that will tell us the sales price. Okay, so let's start out by finding out how much the discount was. So we'll call that x. That's the 10% that's taken off. And that will be the numerator of a fraction. The denominator will be the original price, 495. We'll take that fraction or ratio and set it equal to the percent, which was 10%. And I'm going to write that 10% as a fraction, 10 over 100. Now I want to solve for x, which means I want to get the x all by itself. I'll multiply both sides by 495. 495 on the left side will cancel out, and I just have x. Then I've got to work with the fraction on the right, so I've got 10 times 495. That's 4,950. I want to divide that by 100. And all I have to do is take the decimal point at the end of 4,950, there would be a decimal point there, move it two places to the left, and that would divide it by 100. So I'm going to have x equals $49.50. So that's the discount. Now what we want to do is subtract that number from the original price. The original price was $495, and the discount, the amount I'm subtracting, is $49 $1.50. Okay, so let's do the subtraction. 0 from 0 is 0. I want to subtract 5 from this 0, which means actually I'm going to have to borrow a 1. So the 5 over here becomes a 4, and the 0 becomes a 10. 5 from 10 is 5. I need to subtract 9 from 4, so once again I'll have to borrow. I'll take the 9, turn it into an 8, the 4 becomes a 14. 9 from 14 is 5. And I've got 4 from 8, that's 4. I'll bring down the last 4. And the final price for the bike is going to be $445.50. Okay, so I hope this helps. Take care. I'll see you next time.